Salem, North Carolina for the 2016 Hoop Cities Invitational, coming to you live. In the quarters, I am Marcus Shockley with Netcast Sports, and we are underway. I'll do my best to get you up to speed on the name and numbers. We're here for five games of action all day, and this is our third game of the day. And I would say we are bordering on a packed house right now. So right away, we've got a foul on the floor. No score yet. 7:49 left to play. And Forest Trail looking to get on the board, and they do. And I believe that was, it may be Laisha Williamson at the line. Second bucket for Laisha is good as well. 2-0 now, the lead. Forest Trail first to strike, as both teams looking to win. These are two strong programs. Winston-Salem Prep is the reigning 1A high school girls champion. And here in Winston-Salem, or the Winston-Salem Triad area, they have probably most of the last 10 champions between Winston-Salem Prep and Bishop McGinnis. These two, Bishop and Winston-Salem Prep, play each other twice a year. They're both in the same conference. 1A foul under the basket, and that's going to send Winston-Salem Prep to the line. Kalia Robinson now get her first chance to get Winston-Salem Prep on the board. First shot rattles in, and that will be the first points of the game for Prep. The Phoenix here playing on their first, on their home floor for the Hoop Cities Invitational, brought to you on Netcast Sports as well as by Champion. Big rebound there by Kristen Boston, number 32. A lot of people consider her to be a Division I prospect. Shot no good, going the other direction now. Leasia Williamson running the point, score on the other end, and the Phoenix are a little frustrated here early. 4-2 now in favor of Forest Trail. First year of basketball for Forest Trail, and so they're a new school, private school here in the area. But they've come out strong. Earlier we saw the boys taking on West Forsyth, and now the girls team is here in a battle of titans between Winston-Salem Prep and Forest Trail. And no doubt most of these girls are very familiar with each other, seeing as how they all play within the same area. .622 now left in the first. Williamson drives, and that is going to be a charge on Williamson. And that's going to turn the ball over to Winston-Salem Prep. Robinson to inbound. Jada Craig, an ETSU commit, now running the point for Winston-Salem Prep. Cross-court pass back over to Craig. Craig drives, fakes to the right, drives left, right to the middle. No good by Craig. She gets her own rebound, feeds it back out, but that's out of bounds off the hands of Christina Caesar. So once again, Williamson running the point for Trail. They get for Forest Trail as they get their chance. As they ran out of baseline, ran on a sideline, I should say. The offense. And Forest Trail trying a little jump and trap out there on the outside for the senior.
was.
Williamson looking. And they're going to call a block. It's a little weird, I think. I didn't quite see it, though. Craig now walks it up, tosses it the outside there to Caesar. Stolen on the outside. Forest Trail with a chance to break, but they don't have numbers. Probably should pull it up. Barisha Gill was flashing in the post there, but they didn't get it to her. Nice up and under move there by Gill. And she drives, isn't able to finish, but she's going to get a chance at the line. First shot good by Gill. That will push Forest Trail's lead up to three. Two in a row for Gill. Nice looking stroke. She has a high release there. And now that gives Forest Trail, the visiting Forest Trail, a four-point lead. Harassing defense by Forest Trail, but they leave the shooter open on the outside. That time they sort of dodge a bullet. Dive on the floor, both teams scrambling for it. And another bank shot, good, by Kalia Robinson. Drive. Tough defense by Craig altered that shot. And that's going to stay with Forest Trail. 3:31 left here in the first period. We're coming to you live from Winston-Salem, North Carolina, here at the 2016 Hoop Cities Invitational. We're in game three of a five-game stretch. Feet inside to Gill. She wants to go to work. Nice spin move. Can't finish. Really good drop step there by Gill. She has nice quick feet. Now Robinson bringing the ball up as Craig is going to the bench. You see there's going to be a substitution coming up for Prep as well. Kristen Saunders, the big 6'2 center. Power forward center. She's going to be checking in. Deep outside shot. That shot is short. So Forest Trail, they get a chance to run their offense. No transition opportunity that time. A little behind the back move. Some shake and bake up. And she draws the foul. And that's Lucky Rudd. And now Rudd to the line. A chance to keep her team out in front. They've enjoyed a lead for this game so far, but nobody's really been able to pull away. First shot good by Rudd. 2:42 left here in the first period, and that's going to give a chance for the lineup changes. Kristen Saunders, number 42, in, and she'll be working the baseline. And then also brings back Jada Craig, the starting point guard for the Winston-Salem Prep. Full court press being employed now by Forest Trail. They want to disrupt that lineup that they just employed, and it does stop them a little bit, but the Phoenix are able to scramble and get around it, and they score inside. Robinson with the bucket. Keeping the score close, now only down by two. 2:20 left in the first period. Gill wants a pick. She decides to keep it. That's a long distance. And I'm sorry, that's not. It is Gill, yeah. Did not like where she picked the ball up, but she decided, look, if you guys aren't going to, the guards aren't going to come out and take this ball from me, I'm going to just keep it. And she works it inside, puts her team up by four, and she's got a chance for the and one. Early going here, she's made a living here at the free throw line. And that shot doesn't go for 2 for 3 from the line now for Gill. But I'm sure that the Winston-Salem Prep coaches are trying to figure out how they're going to adjust for her. She's got some good quickness. They have, you know, I believe that's probably why they put Saunders in to add some size. Good hustle points and put back there by Robinson, the senior. Cuts that lead to 2. Prep looking to work the ball inside, and that's going to be a foul on Gill. Tough call. She doesn't like it, but it did look like she grabbed a bit of the arm inadvertently. And technically grabbing the arm by itself isn't always a foul, but at that time she got just enough to get the call and have it go against her. Now Craig draws 2 defenders. Some nifty ball handling in the backcourt by Craig. She tries to split the defense, and she does effectively do so because she's able to draw the foul. That's going to be a side out over here. Just on the near side for Winston-Salem Prep. Still only down by 2 with 1:04 left here in the first period. It's Craig wide open to the inside. Nice passing. That's a great vision. But Forest Trail is able to adjust. And unfortunately not able to score, but they do keep the ball. Winston-Salem Prep kicks it out over the top to Craig. Craig looking to go right, feeds it back inside. Forest Trail employing a zone now with the size of Winston-Salem Prep, and it looks like Jada Craig is determined to work the weak spot of that zone right in the middle. Let's see, they're pulling the 2 guards out to try to defend her, and Craig is trying to go right inside with it. That time she gives it up to the outside. And they go over the top. That's going to be tapped out. I believe Forest Trail may have been the last to touch it, but nope. It looks like Prep. So Forest Trail will get a defensive stop on that end of the floor. 37.3 seconds left here in the first period. Williamson now bringing the ball to the outside. Rudd down here in the corner. Wide open on the outside here is Rudd. Feed inside, or I'm sorry, drive and slash score by Yasia Williamson. The 00 Williamson, very quick, and that pushes Forest Trail out to a 4-point lead. 17.9 seconds left here in the first period. Craig once again drawing those 2 defenders as the zone is, they're employing a very stretched zone out right now. Big rebound for Gill, gives it up to Rudd. And now back to Williamson. Williamson drives right, goes back to her left. Can't get the shot to fall, gets knocked to the floor. And that's going to end it for the first period. 14-10 here from Winston-Salem, North Carolina. 14-10 in favor of Forest Trail. We'll be back in just a few moments with the second period. All right, second period about to get underway here from Winston-Salem, North Carolina. 2016 is only a few days old. We're starting it off with a bang. Five games in one day here at Winston-Salem Prep, the 2016 Hoop Cities Invitational, brought to you by Champion on netcastsports.com. I am Marcus Shockley, and we're underway. 14-10 now in favor of Forest Trail in a home, I'm sorry, in the Road Blacks. Forest Trail running the point. Williamson switched sides. Build, it does look like Jada Craig has a bit of an advantage. That time doesn't go. Getting the bucket, and now Winston-Salem Prep has stormed back to take a two-point lead. 6 minutes now in the half, and that's going to be a kick ball, I believe, on Jada Craig. Two more games after this. We got some great boys action lined up. Coming up, we have R.J. Reynolds is the nightcap against IC Norcom out of the number two school in Virginia. And R.J. Reynolds, number one school, at least in ranking in the area. Lucky Rudd driving, getting knocked to the floor. Teammates helping her up now as she's going to get a chance to get two shots at the line. Rudd shot, good, and cuts the lead to one. Forest Trail has led most of this game, but now that Prep has taken the lead, it's been a back and forth affair. Even though Forest Trail, this is their first year of existence, several of these players actually played in that same area at Thomasville Prep and in the New Hope area. I think they all play in the same gym or around the same area, so. Winston-Salem Prep getting harassed now by Forest Trail, but working the ball around the perimeter. Feed inside, but she's a long way from the basket. Decides to give it back up. Tough defense, but Prep's able to hold on to it. Now here's Craig. No shot clock at the high school level here in North Carolina, and that's benefiting Winston-Salem Prep right now. And that's tough for the defense. They can play tough defense, but they have to force a turnover somehow. And so far, Prep is more than happy to try to wait for the best shot. And that's going to be a turnover. So Forest Trail sticks with their defense. They get the turnover they were looking for. And now they've got a chance to take the lead if they can score on this next possession. Inbound from Timber Tate to Williamson. Outside deep shot is no good by Leah Church. Some of our viewers may remember Leah Church from some of the showcases and stuff that we broadcast a few months back in the late summer. She's a pretty good shooter from the outside. She wasn't able to connect on that one, but she is one of the deep threats. Meanwhile, Winston-Salem Prep has scored again, 19-15. Now they have a four-point lead, and they get a good defensive play. An outlet pass and finish. That's some bang bang play right there. And there's going to be a timeout on the floor. Forest Trail does not like what they just saw. 21-15 now in favor of Winston-Salem Prep. 4:19 left in the half. Some good defense turned into offense for Winston-Salem Prep here on Netcast Sports. Want to talk to you guys about some of the events coming up. In just over the winter, we've got some more basketball for you, some high school basketball. We've got some ECBL, which is the minor league, semi-pro minor league basketball in the region, the Southeast region. Some great basketball. Some of those teams played in the TBT. That's the $1 million basketball tournament. And the primetime players from the ECBL advanced to, I think, the next to last round. I apologize if I'm not getting that exactly right, but I know that they made it deep in that tournament. It's a quality league. We're looking forward to it. We've got some Phenom Hoop stuff coming up and a whole lot of great stuff. So stay tuned to Netcast Sports. Back in action here, fake and drive by Lucky Rudd. And She uses all the rim, the backboard, and the rim again, and that scores. That cuts the lead down. Some much-needed points for Forest Trail. 4 minutes exactly left here in the half. Now they've got a point guard switch defensively, and Jada Craig is going to try to take advantage of that. And she does. Ball slapped away. But Kristen Boston, the center, was able to gather that up after the ball was knocked loose, and she draws the foul. She's going back to the line. 21-17 now. Still in favor of Winston-Salem Prep on their home floor. Ball is out, stays with Winston-Salem Prep. A lucky break for them. And they are looking to capitalize. And now there's a, well, not a stoppage in play. This looks like we've got a substitution. And I believe Robinson is leaving for Winston-Salem Prep. Oh, wide open on the inside and score by Christina Caesar, number 12. Some poor defense, and Winston-Salem Prep took advantage of that. 23-17 now, 3:30 left to go here in the half. Forest Trail kind of looking for some consistency, and they can get it from Timber Tate. Deep outside shot, first time we've called her name on the offensive end tonight, but she's got good length. And that time she just stops and drops in a three pretty easily. Forest Trail boys team now coming out of the locker room. They had a tough game against West Forsyth earlier today. Carrington Matthias now running the point. She's calling out instructions for her teammates. She wants a pick. The teammates are running some banana screens on the backside. And Leah Church is running all over the floor trying to get open. And eventually they do find somebody. And that cuts the lead to one. Forest Trail definitely looking to run some motion offense on that last possession. 2:20 now left in the half. And there's some tough defense on the outside, but that's going to be a foul. It's either going to be on Church or Matthias. And I believe that is going to be on Carrington Matthias, number 12. And she's going to go to the bench as well as Leah Church. And meanwhile, we've got Michaela Wolf at the line. And her first free throw is good. That pushes the lead out 24-22. Want to let you guys know you can follow us on Netcast Sports at Netcast Sports on Twitter. And we usually announce the links and things, the game links and things like that day of the event. Second shot was good for Wolf. 25-22, 2:16 left here in the half. And one of the things about the Twitter account is for the AAU events and things like that, we don't always know the time. So it's good to have like a news feed. Ball out, just dribbled out. Tough defense by the Phoenix. And I would have to say that both teams are still playing very hard, but the Phoenix just seem to have a little bit quicker step on the defensive end those last couple of transition. But then Lucky Rudd looking to change that. Dives in the passing lane there and knocks it out. It's going to stay with Winston-Salem Prep. Over the top, nice pass from Caesar, looking to get it to Boston. They just weren't able to connect. Winston-Salem Prep has a good knack. Several of their guards have a good knack of just lobbing the ball over the defense, over the zone, right into the pocket of the baseline there. Drive by Rudd and finish And she asked for the foul. It did look like she got hit across the face, across the brow there. But no call, but the shot is still good. 25-24 now in favor of Winston-Salem Prep, and we've got an offensive foul. I believe that might have been called on Olivia Nunn, number 32, but I'm not sure. Under the paint, you know, in the paint there. Still, Winston-Salem Prep with the one-point lead. Forest Trail now with a chance to retake the lead for the first time since the first period. 1:22 left in the half. And now we are bordering on a packed house. Deep outside shot is short by Timber Tate. That one was more contested than the one she took earlier in the day. Tate does have a very high fluid release, but that time she never got her feet set. And you have to credit the Winston-Salem Prep defense for that. They adjusted to her on that one. Drive and finish. Just like that, Forest Trail's retaking the lead on Rudd's driving layup. Oh, that's going to be a travel. Unfortunate for Christina Caesar, but she just wanted to step back and survey the offense and lost her footing, I think, on her pivot foot. But the result is a turnover, and that's going to give Forest Trail a chance to run this down for one possession. We have 30 seconds left on the clock here in the first half. And I know that's exactly what they want to do, but they leave Rudd a gap, and she drives and gets herself to the line. She isn't able to finish, but Prep just left that entire left side of the baseline open. The strong, everybody, I think they had one defender over there and four defenders over to the right. And the result is Rudd saw that and took off for the hoop. Second shot good by Rudd. She's really been coming on here in this second period, and a big reason why her team has been able to get back into the lead. Leah Church now back in for Forest Trail as well, number 20. Feet inside, Prep wanting to work it over the top. No good, battling a big rebound, but lost. And now here's Church, open shot, deep shot by Church. No good, and I know she wanted to hit that one. She can hit those deep shots. 27-25 at the half in favor of Forest Trail. Back and forth affair. I'm sure we'll see more of that in the second half. You're watching the 2016 Hoop Cities Invitational here from Winston-Salem Prep in Winston-Salem, North Carolina on Netcast Sports. We'll be back in about 10 minutes. And we'll see you then.
All right, everybody, we are about a minute away from the second half, third period here at the Hoop Cities 2016 Invitational. I am Marcus Shockley with Netcast Sports. We're coming from Winston-Salem Prep Academy in Winston-Salem, North Carolina, as you would imagine. Right now, Forest Trail up by two, 27-25, under a minute. And now we just see Winston-Salem Prep filtering back from the locker room. And they're taking on Forest Trail. Forest Trail wearing the road blacks. Winston-Salem Prep wearing the home whites. Both the Forest Trail girls and boys are playing today, as well as Winston-Salem Prep. This is Prep's home floor. And one of our favorite places to broadcast from. Coach Gould and staff always make us feel welcome here at Netcast Sports. And we are underway. Jada Craig once again running the point for Winston-Salem Prep. Steal on the outside by Williamson. Williamson has quick hands and feet, and she's using them effectively. She's had some trouble defending against Craig, but I think she's one of the few on trail, Forest Trail, that could compete with Craig at the point guard spot. Timber Tate now. Looked like she wanted to feed the ball to a cutting run underneath, but thought better of it. Church back outside to Williamson. Williamson drives, finds herself all alone on the inside, cannot finish. Rebound brought down by Michaela Wolf. Back over to Craig. Wolf feeds it inside to Caesar. And now up and good by Chrislyn Boston. And just like that, Winston-Salem Prep ties the game back up. 7:20 left here in the third. I want to thank my crew today as they are working a long marathon of games. Big, deep outside shot for Forest Trail now. Forest Trail has a few players that are extremely effective shooters. Leah Church, Rudd can also shoot. Timber Tate earlier drilled a three. Prep inbounding. Out to Craig. Jada Craig, as I mentioned, is an East Tennessee State commit. Winston-Salem Prep cutting the lead to one now. 6:30 left here in the third period. A little cross over there by Williamson, but she's not able to shake Craig. Good defensive lateral movement by Craig. And she stays with it, but ultimately Williamson is able to draw the foul on Craig. And that is going to send Williamson to the line. 0-0. Both shots good by Williamson. And that pushes the Forest Trail lead out 32-29, 6:20 left to go here in the third. A little crossover and finish underneath. Winston-Salem Prep has done an extremely good job of feeding the ball inside. Not really just going with pure post play, but just working the ball with interior passing. And now Chrislyn Boston is going to get to the line. A lot of people consider her a Division I prospect. It rolls the ball around the rim and in for the first free throw, cutting the lead to two now. Forest Trail up by a couple of points and now only up by one as Boston's second shot is good. Williamson once again running the point. This is a great point guard matchup that we've enjoyed most of this game. Williamson against Craig. Craig drops back, trying to account for that quickness of Williamson.
I think you could just focus on that point guard matchup alone, and you'd just be watching some great basketball. Now there's a switch, and Williamson is calling out instructions. Williamson drives inside, but she can't get it over the size of Prep on the inside. Now here's Craig in the open court. Splits three defenders and up, and that's going to be a blocking call on Timber Tate. I think Tate was looking to draw the charge, but with three players there, she just couldn't get herself set. She had her own two teammates, and she wasn't able to establish position, and then now Prep's at the line. Craig with a chance to tie with this shot and unable to get that one, so she's got one more coming. 5:38 left here in the third period. We've got one more game coming up in just two more games. I'm sorry. We have IC Norcom out of Virginia taking on R.J. Reynolds in the nightcap at 7:30. And prior to that, we've got a big game between the Winston-Salem Prep boys going on against Middleburg Prep out of Virginia. Two teams from Virginia are coming down to play. So both of those games should be good games. We're bringing in an all-star announcing crew. David Oliveira and L.A. Logan will both be on, and you will enjoy their professional call. Now here's Lucky Rudd on the outside. She looks like she likes to slash. It goes behind her back, loses the dribble just a bit. Back inside to Rudd. She gets free up and can't finish. I think she expected the defender to adjust a little better than they did, and she found herself under the basket. Now going the other direction. Prep still trailing by one. Now they're working the perimeter. They've really looked to go inside as Forest Trail continues to employ that zone, but now doesn't look like they're able to looking to feed the ball in there, and that's going to be a walk. And we've got some moisture, sweat on the ball. Referee's attending to right now. 32-31 in favor of Forest Trail. They still hold that one-point lead. Now they've got possession. 4:51 left here in the third period. I think Forest Trail and Winston-Salem Prep are the only two teams where the boys and girls teams for those schools are both playing today. So we've seen a change at the point guard. Carrington Matthias is back in. Now we've got a turnover and a breakaway for Prep. Over the top to Craig. Craig tries to finish. Good defense there by Leah Church. Now Gill back in the game. Bounces it off of a Winston-Salem Prep player. Barisha Gill had a really strong first half. I haven't called her name before here in the second, so let's see if she can get things going now that she's back on the floor. She's got good footwork. She's really quick with a drop step. She hasn't had a ton of luck since they went to the big lineup with Winston-Salem Prep, but let's see what she can do here. Deep shot, no good. Tracked down by Jordan Tuff. Ball's on the floor. Players are scrambling. And Timber Tate looked like she might have been shaken up a little bit. She's trying to walk it off. Looks like her left ankle could be bothering her just a bit. But Forest Trail winning that hustle play. Neither team really able to establish control of this game yet. Here's Gill trying to go to work. Up and under move, and they're going to call a walk on her. And that did look like she dragged her pivot foot just a little bit. She had a nice looking up and under, but looked like her left foot dragged just enough to get the walk call. Now Craig, she wants to walk it out.
Prep looking for just the right way to probe that zone, and the coach doesn't like it, that the Prep is just too tentative, and there's going to be a timeout on the floor for Winston-Salem Prep. 32-31 in favor of Forest Trail, still clinging to that one-point lead. 3:30 left here in the third period. Coming to you live from Winston-Salem Prep Academy, the 2016 Hoop Cities Invitational on Netcast Sports. See the Winston-Salem Prep coach taking a little bit of extra time to complain to the referee and ask for some explanation on what's going on some specific calls. The referee doing his best to smooth out the situation. So once again, we're coming back into action. 3:30 left here in the third period. Neither team has been able to establish themselves beyond a 1 or 2 point lead throughout the game. And that's where we stand right now, Forest Trail, with a 1 point lead in the third period. Winston-Salem Prep with the ball. Jada Craig being harassed by two defenders on the outside, gets it up to Caesar, who kicks it outside. Back to Craig now. Down to Caesar. She wants to drive it on the inside. Good feed. Over the top of two players. Bank shot good by Chrislyn Boston, the unsigned junior. Boston puts Winston-Salem Prep up by one now with 3 minutes left to go in the third. And tough defense by Winston-Salem Prep forces a turnover, and just like that, where Forest Trail was holding on to a one-point lead for quite some time, now they are trailing by one, and Prep holds his one-point lead. And now Prep wants to be methodical. And Forest Trail wants to extend that zone out. But there's that soft spot in the middle. Good defensive recovery there by Trail. Over the top. Big steal there by Gill. Lucky run over the top. Kicks it outside to Timber Tate. Timber Tate with the deep shot is good. That's 2 out of 3 from deep for Timber Tate now, and that puts Forest Trail back up by two. 2:20 left to go here in the third period. Jada Craig, she's handled that double press pretty well. Feet inside. Winston-Salem Prep, that's been the story of the game, is slashing from the outside and deep shooting by Forest Trail to handle the physical interior passing and movement by Winston-Salem Prep. Now Lucky Rudd running the point. He drives right, tries to feed it inside to Segna Wentz. The ball is tapped out by Winston-Salem Prep. Ball will stay with Forest Trail. Timber Tate to inbound over the top to Rudd. And that's going to be a foul at the top. And that's going to go against Jada Craig. Number 4, Lucky Rudd running the point. She's the third player that's run the point for Forest Trail today. Drives, finds herself open on the outside, but she's really trying to go inside there to Gill. Both times, Rudd was looking to work the ball in, and they have, and Winston-Salem Prep has defended it well. Trail still with that 2 point lead that they seized back just a few moments ago. Now here's Timber Tate on the outside. Looks like she wants to drive and decides not to. Rudd wants to go right. They leave that lane open again, and she finishes inside just like she did earlier in the first half. on the other end of the floor, 37-33, 1:36 left, and Rudd is going back to the line. They cannot leave that side open for her. She's very strong going to the right. And as soon as she pulls out and sees that defense overcommit, she's going to go right to the hoop and make them pay. And she's done it. That's the second time tonight that we've seen her finish and get that hoop in the arm. And now she's got a chance to stretch that lead out to the farthest it's been in a while. And she does, 38-33 now, a five-point lead for Forest Trail. And Rudd almost with the steal, but Prep beats the press. Drive up and no good, but a nice transition opportunity there. And that's going to send Robinson, Kayla Robinson, to the line. The senior, number 23 for Winston-Salem Prep. Setting up for a second shot, and that's good. That's a good bucket. They needed that. 38-34 now, 1:28. Full court pressure. A one-person press here back by Christina Caesar. She's really hounding Rudd. Rudd finally beats her, gets up into the front court, kicks it to the outside. But you really have to hand it to Christina Caesar for Prep on that one. She just relentlessly dogged Rudd all the way up to court and forced the turnover. Forest Trail still employing that zone, but worked effectively that time. And this lineup has worked pretty well for Forest Trail of Timber Tate, Gill, and Lucky Rudd. And now here's Leah Church, known as a shooter, but she drives, and it looks like she's going to draw the foul. And get herself to the line. She's a good free throw shooter. ...50.6 seconds left here in the third period. And now Forest Trail has built a little momentum, and they'd like to close out this period with that momentum and go into the fourth period. And Church's second shot bounces around and in, and 40-34 now, a six-point lead, largest of the ball game for Forest Trail. Prep would like to get a quick point or two here to finish. They drive, turnover. Jade Grant, unfortunately, she was trying to feed it inside, and there was three Forest Trail defenders there. Well, now it looks like Prep is, you know, able to recover, so they want to make something happen. 29 seconds left here in the third. Feet inside. Good look there by Caesar. No good. Bounces off. Timber Tate with the rebound and gets it to Williamson, and it's knocked out, and it's going to be a foul. And it looks like that is going to go against Prep, and that and Forest Trail's in the bonus, so that's going to send Williamson to the line. Forest Trail, and they can build on this lead, and they're really finishing out the third period exactly how they would want to. Up by six at the free throw line with 22 seconds left. Williamson's shot is good. She hits the front end of the 1-1. Getting dark outside here in Winston-Salem, North Carolina, and we've got two big games lined up for you coming up next. Second shot by Williamson is good as well. 42-34. Now this is a big lead. And a foul in the backcourt. They didn't need that. Forest Trail didn't need that, I mean. You know, they had everything going for them, so now they certainly don't want to have that. Prep the inbound. Prep the reigning 1A girls champion, state champion. Feet inside. Nice ball movement by Winston-Salem Prep. A score inside by Kristen Saunders. 7 seconds left on the clock.
just basically enough for a shot or a passing shot. Feet inside, and that's going to be a foul, probably on Saunders. It looked like she came down with the block. Williamson drove right into her.
Winston-Salem Prep, one of the few high schools, I think maybe the only high school I've ever seen that actually has a concession person working in the stands. And, you know, that's big time right there. That's big time. We didn't have to get up. I'm looking over at Liam. We didn't have to get up. I had to go. I could just get a lemonade. I didn't have to go to the concession stand. Shot is good by Williamson, and now 43-36 with 1 second left on the clock. Oh! A ridiculous half-court shot to finish off the third period, and they say it is good. 1 second left. It looked like there was a little bit of delay getting that clock started, but 43-39, that's the way you finish out the third period. Forest Trail with the lead, and all that momentum going for Forest Trail sort of been negated just a bit there by that deep shot right at the end of the third period. We'll be coming back in just a couple of minutes and finish this one up. All right, we're getting ready for the third period. The fourth period. Got my lemonade. Got my chair. I'm ready to kick back and watch this, close this one out before we get ready for the late game festivities. The Prep boys playing Middleburg and Norcom taking on R.J. Reynolds. Right now, Forest Trail up by four. 7:49 left to go in this one. We're just really underway here in the final, and this is getting heated. The gym is pretty packed on the home side. And since most of these players are all from the same area, I imagine everybody's sitting on the same side. Lucky Rudd wanting to drive. That time, Prep tries to cut her off. Did a little bit better job adjusting, but she's very strong driving to her right. There's a finish inside by Williamson. And they're going to call a charge on Williamson. I couldn't see it from my vantage point. Didn't look like it, but I think there was a couple players blocking me, so I'm not really sure. But the result is we're going the other way. And that's the break Prep needed. They really need a couple of good possessions here. 43-39 in favor of Forest Trail. Prep hit a half-court shot to finish up the third period to cut that lead down after it started getting away from them just a bit at the end of the third. And that zone being employed there by Forest Trail has been effective here in the second half. It wasn't quite as effective in the first half. There's a finish inside by Craig, but she can't get it. She gets her own rebound and draws the foul. Jada Craig, the East Tennessee State commit, getting herself to the line. With the clock stop, this is what Prep needs. Prep is actually missing one of their better guards tonight, Dominique Clater. I know that she has not played in about 3 weeks or so, so they're missing some talent on their team, but they're still a deep team. And one of their better players, best player probably, Craig, at the line. Thank you. Craig's shot is good. 43-40. You have to hand it to Winston-Salem Prep. I mean, both teams have had some good runs. I would say Forest Trail pretty much owned that third period, but then with that deep shot that Prep hit it right at the end of the period, and now coming back, they only trail by three. And we've got a lot of time left. 6:53 left in this one. Second shot by Craig, no good. Rebounded by Timber Tate. She gives it up to Williamson. Williamson being guarded by Craig. This is the matchup that I've really enjoyed when these two are going at it. And Williamson tries to get that shot up over Craig. Craig does not foul. Good defense there by Williamson. I mean, sorry, by Craig. And a turnover. Now Prep still down by three. They really want a bucket on this trip if they can. Good feed on the inside, but ball is dribbled off the foot of Chrislyn Boston, and that's too bad because she is very effective, and she had nothing but air between herself and the basket, and she knew it. So unfortunate that time. 6:11 now left in the game. Lucky Rudd now calling out instructions. She's being guarded by Christina Caesar. Rudd wants to go left this time, wants to go back to her right, and that time she loses the ball out of bounds, and that is going to be a foul, much to the chagrin of the crowd, on, I believe, Caesar. And that's going to put Rudd back at the line. Rudd's first shot is good. Second shot coming for Lucky Rudd. She's been a big factor in this second half. And there's going to be a timeout on the floor. I believe that's a 20-second timeout by Forest Trail. 45-40. They have the lead with 6 minutes left to go. And the gym continues to fill up with more fans. We have two premier games coming in just a bit. These guys are, you know, enjoying this game, but we've got some, the Winston-Salem Prep boys are about to play against Middleburg out of Virginia, so there's going to be a home game for Prep. And then we've got R.J. Reynolds taking on IC Norcom out of Virginia. IC Norcom, a highly ranked team. R.J. Reynolds having a very strong season. They're ranked number one in the region. And I would say this is probably going to be a home game for Reynolds as well, since they're not far, their school is not that far from here. Both schools are basically in the downtown area of Winston-Salem, so. But two strong Virginia teams coming in to take on two strong Triad teams. Back in action here, 5:55 left here in the fourth. Nice passing and foul drawn, and that foul is going to be called on Lucky Rudd, I think. And that's going to send Michaela Wolf to the line. We have a player that lost a shoe down here for Winston-Salem Prep, number 23. Kayla Robinson has stepped right out of her shoe. And she is desperately trying to get her shoe back on. And she does. That was an acrobatic move to get that shoe back on. I could have never done what she just did. She just put the shoe on the floor and stepped into it and kept running. 45-43, Winston-Salem Prep finishes. Cut the lead to 2, 5:17 left in this one. Now here's that matchup, Williamson going against Craig. Craig, and that is going to be a charge. Good defense by Jada Craig. She's a little slow to get up. The Winston-Salem Prep boys headed back to the locker room. Their game coming up next. Oh, yeah. feed inside and score by number 12, Christina Caesar, the senior. And now here's the player for Forest Trail in the half, Lucky Rudd. She's been running the point whenever Williamson is out. She really likes to drive to her right. She could go left a bit, but you know she really wants to step back to that right. Deep shot on the outside by number one, Jordan Tuff. Forest Trail goes back up by three. 4:30 left in this one. Now here's Craig. She's been a strong performer for Prep. This is a point that Winston-Salem Prep hasn't been stymied by that zone too often, but this possession and one possession earlier, which forced a timeout, they kind of looked unsure. Now they're moving. When the game gets tight like this and you need those buckets, you know, you don't really want to make mistakes. And I think that's where Prep is looking right now. They're looking to just try to make the right play. Nice feed on the inside. And that looked like tough defense there by Jody Boyd, number 14, but the foul is called on Boyd. First time called Boyd's name tonight, and unfortunately it's for a foul. But the result is that it's going to send, I believe, Christina Caesar to the line. Caesar plays both the guard and forward positions for Prep. And first free throw bounces off the front of the rim. Boyd with a lazy pass there, and that is a bad turnover for Forest Trail. Once again, we see Kayla Robinson back at the line. She went one for two earlier tonight. Now she hits the first one. Now only down by two. Winston-Salem Prep, they've struggled. They have not led this game in quite some time now since the third period, but they are not out of it by any means. They're only down by two. This shot could cut it to one, and it does. Kayla Robinson pulling her team to just within a single digit. 3:44 left. Caesar picking up Rudd full court. Down to Church. She's able to keep it. She drives, loses the ball, and now here we're going the other way. Transition opportunity for Prep. Forest Trail gets back defensively very well. Rudd doesn't foul. Now Prep is forced to move the ball. Trail's able to set up that zone. Robinson in trouble. Kicks it back out. Good pass to Craig. They really want to go inside. There they go. Ball knocked away from Saunders. They have a huge size advantage with Saunders, who's about 6'2". And they really would like to be able to feed the ball into her. And that's why Trail is employing that prep. Zone. There's Saunders. She's got an open look to the basket, and she is fouled. It did not look like anybody was going to get in her way on that one. She was going hard at the basket. It probably was a little too strong with the shot there. But she's at the line with a chance to tie it. First shot is way short. 48-47, 3:01 left in this one. We see Gill coming back in. She's been one of the few people that can handle some of the post play of Prep. And Trail's got probably one of their bigger lineups with Timber Tate and Gill both in. To 48 now. 2:54. Prep has clawed their way back into this especially after that deep run that Forest Trail had in the third period. But now Lucky Rudd's shot puts Forest Trail back up by one. Just under 3 minutes left in this one. Rudd's second shot rattles around the rim and drops, putting her team up by two. We've got a timeout on the floor. Forest Trail leads 50-48 with 2:54 left here on Netcast Sports. I want to thank again Winston-Salem Prep for inviting us in here to help broadcast today's events. And it's been a fun day. We're at game 3 of 5. We have two more coming up, and we will have some barn burner action for the remainder of the day. I appreciate everyone out there. If you're joining us, follow us on Twitter at Netcast Sports. You can keep up with the links. We announce them as the games are getting ready to broadcast and all that sort of good thing. And, you know, you want to be cool, you want to follow us. It's always good to have cool friends. Got some pro stuff coming up in March, April, June. And we'll be doing that again this year, so. So both teams now, we've really gotten down to a point where we're almost like level set. Forest Trail up by two, but there's 3 minutes left. It's really anybody's ball game now. Forest Trail went on that run in the third period, but Prep has pretty much erased that. So now let's see who can establish themselves in this last 3 minutes. Trail still sticking with the zone. They want to go inside to Saunders. Saunders up, too strong again. She can't finish, and that's going to be a foul on Saunders. She reached around Gill. And that's going to send Larisha Gill to the line, number two. I've been impressed with Gill, the senior, during this game. I think she's been one of the few players that's been able to play against Prep in the post, and that's going to send Kristen Saunders to the bench, I think, for Prep. And they may want to try to keep her for later. I don't know what her foul situation is. Hard foul underneath the basket. They're going to call a jump ball. That looked like a WWE takedown to me. A little martial arts action. Prep now looking for the right shot. Craig back in. They want to work the ball around, trying to probe that zone. And there they go, right inside. They find an open shot on the outside, and good, big shot dropped by Michaela Wolf at the right time. That ties it up 50-50. 2 minutes left in this one now. Now here's Rudd. Like I said, she would like to go right if she could. Spin inside by Tate, and no good. And now here's Prep. For a moment, it looked like they had a chance to run, but they couldn't. Forest Trail did a good job of getting back in transition. And we got a timeout on the floor, and Winston-Salem Prep wants to talk this over. Now they've clawed their way back in, 1:42 left, and they want to try to figure out what they can come up with to get a bucket here. One bucket might be enough, the way both of these teams have played defense. 50-50, 1:42 left, and we'll be all wrapped up with this one, barring overtime. Mm-hmm. bleachers on our side over here are pretty full. And on the visitor side, not a ton of people, it doesn't look like. But over on over here on there's two sides. Obviously, there are two sides. There's the smaller home. I mean, so the smaller away bleachers. And then on the opposite side, the entire side of the gym is taller bleachers and everything. They're pretty much full. I'd say they're like 80% full, but packed. Except for right behind us, and I think they're probably not on our end because we're kind of cordoned off this area over here. Feed to Robinson. She decides to pull it back out. Wants to go back inside. Nice pass by Caesar. And they can't finish. And that's going to be a push, I think, by Rudd. She went over the back of Michaela Wolf. Wolf's first shot is good, and now Prep with the first lead that they have had since the third period. 1:25 left. Second shot is good, and that, you know, like I said, one bucket could do it. So 1:25 left. Here's Leah Church to inbound, and Winston-Salem Prep now playing a really tough-nosed full-court press, and that's going to cause Trail to want to call a timeout. More of the boys' teams filing in now. Coming out of Virginia. They've had a long ride. That's one of the things about when you play on the road for this kind of game. You know, in high school, you're hoping that your road games are maybe 30 minutes, 40 minutes down the road at the farthest. It's tough when you have to travel to another state and then play. So let's get set on where we are right now. 1:25 left in this game, 52-50. Winston-Salem Prep now, I wouldn't say they're clinging to a two-point lead, but they had to really fight to get back into this game and then take the lead. Forest Trail went on a big run in the third period and was in the lead for quite some time. Now Trail's looking for some way to reignite their offense. Inbound by Trail. Prep still deploying that full court press, and they throw it away right away, but then Gill's able to gather it up for Trail. So a lucky bounce, and now here's Rudd driving to her right and finish, and there she is. Third time tonight she finishes. That time she does not draw the foul. Ties it up 52-52. 1:11 left in this one. And now here's Craig. Now Prep is, neither team at this point is going to want to rush, but we're down to literally possession by possession attacks. And Prep is looking for the right one. And that's going to be dribbled out. And that is going to go off the foot of Michaela Wolf. So good defense by Rudd. Earlier, just a couple of plays ago, Rudd was battling with Wolf for a rebound and fouled her. And now it looks like it's going the other way as Rudd is able to get the turnover. Now Trail. And we've got a loose ball foul on. It looks like we've got a loose ball foul, a hold on Michaela Wolf against Leah Church. And it looks like that's going to send Church to the line because they're in the bonus. 56.1 seconds left. That's a tough call for Winston-Salem Prep. That is not what they wanted. They haven't really employed that full court press this game until just now. And they were playing extremely tight defense. So sometimes that kind of thing is going to happen. But that puts a very good free throw shooter on the line in Leah Church. She drops the first one. Second shot by Church is good. I don't believe she's missed any today. 50 seconds left here. Prep desperately needs a bucket.
drive up and no good. Rebounded by Gill. Big rebound. And now she's looking for an outlet pass, and she is fouled hard by Robinson. That's good. It's a good foul to stop the clock. Tough miss for Prep, and that's going to send Gill to the line. Barisha Gill, number two. 40 seconds left on the clock. These could be huge free throws if Gill can sink these. And the first one is no good, so she's basically now trying to still keep this at a one-possession game to make it a harder one possession. Standing room only right now on the baseline on the far side. Second shot is good by Gill. Three-point lead for Trail. Under 40 seconds now. Prep looking to work. Forest Trail extending that zone, and there's going to be a timeout on the floor by Winston-Salem Prep to talk things over. Good choice by them. 29.6 seconds left. As I've said, we've got Winston-Salem Prep boys taking on Middleburg Prep from Virginia coming up next. They'll have David Oliveira and L.A. Logan on the call. And those should be some exciting ways to finish up this full day of basketball. So what Prep wants to do here, they have not effectively shot the ball from deep. Ideally, what they would want, feed the ball inside, score, and get themselves to the line for the and-one opportunity. That's a huge steal by Lucky Rudd on the outside, and Craig dove for it. Now Rudd open, and they're going to have to foul. Caesar had to dive for Rudd's arm there. Just Lucky Rudd diving in front of that pass and getting herself to the line now. Now building off of the free throw that Gill hit just earlier, Rudd could really, really put themselves in a strong position with these free throws. And she does put them up now by two possessions, 56-52. 24.7 seconds left on the clock. Second shot coming for Rudd. Cool as ice. Lucky Rudd drops that second one now up 57-52. They're up by five. Deep shot and no good. Ball up and now there's a battle inside. And Gill with another rebound. That is two huge rebounds for Barisha Gill. And now she's going back to the line. Now 14.9 seconds left. Gill's first shot is good, and that could do it. 58-52, now by six. Still a two possession game. Now this one, if she can hit this last free throw, it would be very hard for Prep to be able to pull off three possessions in the last 15 seconds. So they're going to roll the ball up. So Trail's going to let them, but pick it up. But now they're going to pick up in a half-court press. And Gill taps it out of bounds. 10.9 seconds left on the clock. 7-point lead. Prep over the top. Knocked out now by Timber Tate. Now here's Craig. She's just going to drive. Any shot would be a good shot at this point for Prep. And ball bounces out. Rudd grabs it, and that's going to do it. 1 point, 1 second left of the clock. 59-52. Forest Trail comes into Winston-Salem Prep and leaves with the win on the road. And that's going to do it. Coming up next, we've got Middleburg Academy versus Winston-Salem Prep. Stay tuned for that one here on Netcast Sports. Thanks a lot.